In this video, we're going to look at 7 professional tools that you can use with the Blackmagic Camera app on your iPhone. 1, Follow Focus. The Blackmagic Camera app is compatible with the Tilta Nucleus Follow Focus family. I'm demoing the Nucleus M. Step 1, enable Bluetooth on your Nucleus controller. Step 2, head to Options in the Blackmagic Camera app, enable Bluetooth, and then select the Nucleus controller. The focus wheel controls focus. The zoom button controls digital zoom. Now a first AC can control focus without needing access to the screen. And even though this camera's sensors are tiny, the tighter focal lengths do have respectable depth of field. Depth of field gets even shallower when using third-party lenses like this Moment lens. 2, video monitoring. You'll need a dongle for this. You could use a HDMI-only dongle, but I'm going to use this larger dongle so I can attach more accessories to my iPhone. Connect your monitor via HDMI. By default, the camera app outputs the interface and controls to the external monitor. If you'd prefer a clean feed, there's an option you can enable in the settings. Latency is respectable. It's certainly sufficient for monitoring. There's a 4-frame delay on the iPhone and an 8-frame delay on the connected HDMI monitor. 3, Timecode. The Blackmagic Camera app supports the popular Tentacle Sync timecode system. Here, I've got a Tentacle connected to my Kinefinity Marvo LF. I've also got one connected to my Zoom F4 audio recorder. As long as Bluetooth is turned on, the Blackmagic Camera app will find nearby tentacles and jam sync its own timecode. 4, wired microphones. By default, the Blackmagic Camera app will record using the iPhone's internal microphones. Professional microphones can be connected via the USB-C port. I'm going to demo 2 devices. The first is this Tascam X6 Porter Capture. It's got 2 inbuilt stereo microphones that I could use, but instead I'm using this high-end large diaphragm condenser stereo microphone from Audio Technica. Within the Blackmagic Camera app settings, the X6 can now be selected. If you're filming in a home studio, you might find a desktop device like this Motu M4 is more appropriate. You can use either I/O device to connect professional headphones for monitoring. 5, what about wireless microphones? Here's 3 options. Firstly, because we've got accurate timecode, we could just use one of these, a Tentacle Track E. This isn't connecting wirelessly to the iPhone. It's recording audio separately, but because it's got accurate timecode, it can be synced in post. The next option is something like a Rode Wireless Go. This is a consumer wireless system. The quality is good enough for most scenarios, and its size and ease of operations suits the iPhone well. It attaches directly via USB-C. 3rd, what if you want to use a more serious professional wireless solution? Something like a Sennheiser EWDP. I'm connecting this via a USB-C to headphone adapter. With a system like this, you can connect high-end professional microphones wirelessly to your iPhone. 6, View LUTs. How can you use the app with DaVinci Resolve? I'm not just talking about transferring your footage to and then editing on DaVinci Resolve. I'm talking about using Resolve to improve your experience while you're shooting. To record the highest quality possible image from your iPhone, you'll want to use the Apple Log color space. To monitor your image properly, you'll need to load an Apple Log to Rec. 709 LUT. You can create one of these using DaVinci Resolve. I'm working non-color managed. It doesn't matter what clip you're working with, add a color space transform effect to your node, configure it to convert from Apple Log to Rec. 709. That's Rec. 2020 and Apple Log for the input, and Rec. 709 Gamma 2.4 for the output. Right-click on the clip and go to Generate LUT. A 33-point LUT is a nice compromise. Transfer this to a storage location that you can access on your iPhone, and then load the LUT into the Blackmagic Camera app. Now you can shoot in Apple Log while viewing a properly normalized image. 7, external storage. Here is a super fast SSD. You can attach it directly to the iPhone's USB-C port or via a dongle. Head to the app's options and find the Save Clips To option. From here, you can navigate to the specific folder on your attached drive that you want to save your footage to. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and consider sharing it. We're planning some really cool future content about professional workflows with the Blackmagic Camera app and DaVinci Resolve. So if you'd like to see that, please make sure you subscribe so you don't miss it. Thanks for watching.